Hi everyone, in this video, I'm going to talk about what foods fight cancer. You know, there's emerging evidence that epigenetics, that is to say, environmental influences on our genes, such as nutrition, can affect genetic expression in a positive manner. While you can't control what genes you have, you can influence the way they are expressed and influence your health. Specifically, the foods we eat can have an impact on the messages our cell DNA receives for cell division, both good or bad. For example, the author of an article in the mainstream journal Cancer Treatment and Research notes, many natural dietary agents, which consist of bioactive compounds, have been shown to be effective in cancer prevention and treatment. And these nutraceuticals often mediate favorable epigenetic changes. You know, researchers from around the world have compiled data on foods that decrease cancer risk. This is taken from 7,000 scientific studies that were independently reviewed by 21 world-renowned scientists. Here are some of the high points of what they found. For example, there's strong evidence on what decreases cancer risk. And this includes fiber-rich foods. They've been shown to decrease the risk of cancer of the bowel, such as colorectal cancer, and blood cancers. This includes lymphoid cancers as well. Examples of these foods include vegetables, fruits, nuts, seeds, and pulses. Although whole grain varieties of cereals, pasta, rice, and bread are also high in dietary fiber, I generally don't recommend them as part of a healthy diet because they're so high in simple carbs, they spike insulin levels, which are carcinogenic. They also found that non-starchy vegetables decrease the risk of cancer of the mouth, pharynx, and larynx, which is the mouth and thyroid areas, as well as thyroid. Examples of non-starchy vegetables include broccoli, cabbage, spinach, as well as kale, cauliflower, carrots, lettuce, cucumbers, tomatoes, leek, rutabaga, and turnip. In addition, fruit was found to decrease the risk of cancer of the lung, mouth, and mouth and throat. Now for dairy products, they were found to decrease the risk of cancer of the bowel, again colorectal cancer. However, we know that calcium-rich foods can increase the risk of prostate cancer and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. As well, a high percent of the population has lactose intolerance, where they can't digest milk sugar. So I don't recommend vast amounts of dairy products. Now, interestingly, they found that coffee lowers the risk of cancer of the liver, as well as endometrial cancer. However, I think green tea is a much better option overall for general cancer prevention because we have so many studies showing that green tea has an anti-cancer effect. So overall, it's not surprising that diets that contain higher amounts of plant foods are protective. One diet that has a lot of cancer preventative research is the Mediterranean diet, which generally consists of fruits, vegetables, extra virgin olive oil, fish, whole grains, legumes, and moderate amounts of wine and small amounts of red meat. For example, one study of over 380,000 people from the United States found the Mediterranean diet decreased cancer mortality in men by 17% and for women 12% after 5 years of follow-up. Other studies have demonstrated the anti-cancer properties of the Mediterranean diet for colorectal, breast, liver, stomach, prostate, and esophageal cancers.
Be sure to get your copy of Outside the Box Cancer Therapies by naturopathic medical doctors Mark Stengler and Paul Anderson. Available now wherever fine books are sold.